I'm Ben.
I'm Fitz.
We're going to answer some more questions about working at Google.
Actually, we're going to answer one question.
All right, one question.
Okay.
You got it there on your G-pad?
I've got it. It's ready on my G-pad.
Excellent.
Freshly charged. So here's the question. Who approves or rejects the innovative ideas that you have? And that's from Anka EU in Toulouse, France.
It's interesting because I think this question sort of assumes a traditional corporate structure where there's a chain of command, and you know the orders come down from one person to the other. And if you have an idea, then you have to go through some very formal process up through the chain and down through the chain. And that kind of bureaucracy really doesn't exist here. It's a very, what would you say?
When somebody comes up to you, I want you to have an idea right now.
No, but it's a very flat organization at Google.
Right.
I mean, there is some hierarchy, but very little compared to what you would expect. It's most of the time it's just sort of, as someone described it, a lot of mad scientists running around trying crazy new things and sort of ideas bubbling up from the bottom. And then you've got a very thin middle layer of management and product management who sort of are noticing the innovations and saying, hey, that's a great idea. Let's turn that into a feature or a product or
right.
something, right? It's not a top down.
Right, but I want to sort of actually back up to the idea part
and okay.
debunk the general concept that ideas are something that are approved or disapproved. My personal view is that ideas are worthless. 99% of the ideas that come out of anyone, myself included, especially myself, are just garbage. I have 20 different ideas walking to work in the morning, right? The fact of the matter is that what really gets to a point where it's even something to contemplate or quote-unquote approve is when you have something that's fleshed out as an idea, a prototype perhaps, a design document, or the opportunity to bounce it off some other people and get some more input on that.
This goes back to the execution is what matters, not just having a thought.
Right.
And even the beginning of execution matters way, way more, right? Like having a design document, having a demo, having something. Yeah.
Right. If you go up to a bunch of folks and say, hey, I have this great idea, then people might be, oh, yeah, well, whatever, you know, is that possible? Can you do this? Once you start to explore it, whether it's through a quick prototype, which is probably the best way to go, or a design doc, then you're going to start getting ideas of, is this going to work? Is this not going to work? Here are some of the hard parts. Here are some of the easy parts.
So by the time you're actually ready to show it to somebody who really does have the power to say, yes, you know, we'll have some people work on this with you.
Or we'll spend more time on this or commit something.
But you've already learned a lot about the problem. You've already got something sort of working. And so it's not just a hypothetical, throw a bunch of people at this idea.
It comes back to that sort of, you never want to do something the first time in front of other people, right? So when we went out to interview, right, what did we knew we were going to have to write code on a whiteboard. So we sat down with pencil and paper and practiced writing code on pencil and paper.
Makes a big difference. Yeah.
It does. The first time I did it, I felt like I'd had a lobotomy, right? You know, I was so used to writing a code with my compiler right there to help me out. And so for a prototype is a way of sort of getting that first shot at it, right? And you can work through some of the hard problems or find out some of the catching points before you go in front of someone else and say, you know, this is
right.
my idea, this is my prototype.
Yeah, so I'd say that's the general process is if you have an idea at Google and something that you feel like you want to really shop around or get approval or get other people to look at, the first thing I would do is I guess I would use my 20% time to
right.
try and implement and maybe convince some coworkers around me, hey, you want to work on this with me on your 20% time? Let's band together and see if we can come up with a proof of concept.
Right, getting more people
to
buy into that is really important.
And so if you can create like a small group of people who are all doing 20% on something and then you get something that is actually demoable, then you show that to somebody else and then the idea will catch on. That's the hope. And that's how a lot of projects get started here. Right?
Yeah.
But it's not just, you know, I have an idea, I'll go talk to the VP and he'll say yes or no. It's not that simple.
And I think a lot of it depends. Is this a new product or is this a feature for an existing product?
Right.
Because if it's a feature in an existing product, especially if it's a product that you're working on currently, I think it's a lot easier to sort of get that ball rolling because you can bounce it off your team, your product manager, and see, okay, where can we fit this in? And then if it's something that you can accomplish in your 20% time, it does make it easier to sort of get that into there. Because a lot of the issue is in general is that as nice as it would be, engineering resources are finite. So you've got to pick and choose what's more important. Is it more important to fix this bug that's affecting so many people? Is it more important to write this new feature? Or is it more important to just implement this idea I just came up with?
Cool.
All right.
I think we're set.
Thanks a lot.
See you next time.
Bye-bye.